Good morning. The lecture topic, the intake and movement of nutrients in plants. Lecture plan. First, the intake of nutrients in plants. Second, upward current of nutrients. Third, the cycle of mineral elements in the plant reutilization. Where do plants get their nutrients? Plant sugar factory. Nutrients availability and soil. The relative availability of nutrients to plant roots depends on the pH level of the soil. Plant nutrients content in percent compared to nitrogen. Average composition of plant. Nutrients deficiency symptoms on leaves. The most common symptoms of nutrient deficiency are stunted growth and leaf discoloration. The position of the symptoms, distal, basal, or intermediate, depends on the mobility of the nutrient inside the plant. Young leaves competing with old leaves. Mobile nutrients identification K. Mobile nutrients. Immobile nutrients identification K. Nitrogen. Nitrogen is a building block of plant's protein. It's an integral part of chlorophyll and is a component of amino acids, nucleic acids, and coenzymes. Most nitrogen in the soil is tied up in organic matter. It is taken up by plants as nitrate and ammonium ions from inorganic nitrate and ammonium compounds. These compounds can enter the soil as a result of bacterial action, nitrogen fixation, application of inorganic nitrogen, fertilizer, or conversion of organic matter into ammonium and nitrate compounds. Not all nitrates in the soil are taken up by plants. Nitrates can be leached beyond the root zone in sandy soil or converted to nitrogen gas in wet, flooded soil. Nitrogen fixation from atmosphere. By soil microbes immobilize nitrogen, making it available for later use by plants. Nitrogen hints. Deficiency symptoms. Slow growth and starting yellow-green color leaves. Firing of tips and margin of leaves. Yellowing begins with mature leaves. Fertilizer sources. The first number on bag of inorganic fertilizer refers to the amount of pure nitrogen per 100 pounds of fertilizer. Most plants depend on bacteria to supply nitrogen. The use of labeled phosphorus made it possible to establish that the movement of salts is faster with increased transpiration and slow down with decrease in this process. These experiments will allow us to calculate that the movement of nutrients in the ascending direction goes along the xylem vessels with water. Symbiotic nitrogen fixation. Nitrogen inputs, outputs. Relative importance of the main inputs on outputs in the nitrogen balance. Agriculture and overall nitrogen balance. Nitrogen from fall to springtime. the cycle of minerals in the plant. This is expressed in the ability of the plant to reuse the basic elements of mineral nutrition. Phosphorus compounds are especially mobile in plants. Phosphorus. Plants use phosphorus to form the nucleic acids DNA and RNA and to store and transfer energy. Phosphorus promotes early plant growth and root formation through its role in the division and organization of cells. Phosphorus is essential to flowering and fruiting and to the transfer of hereditary traits. Phosphorus is absorbed by plants depending upon soil pH. The mobility of phosphorus in soil is low, and deficiency are common in the wet soil. Phosphorus should be applied to fields and garden before planting and should be incorporated into the soil. This is especially important for perennial crops. Application rates should be based on soil testing. Interesting result we obtained in experiment with corn. Maize seedling at the age of 10 days were transferred to a nutrient medium containing. Then each newly appearing leaf in the ratio of determined. It turned out that it was the same in all, as the outflows of phosphorus from the leaves of all the leaves went to young leaves. Further studies have shown that the majority of mineral nutrition items are moved by roots. However, there are elements that are practically not reutilized. This is due to the low mobility and poor solubility in which this element enter. Plant hormones. What is a hormone? It must meet this criteria. An endogenous organic compound. Next, active at very low concentration, produced in one tissue, transported from the site of synthesis to the tissue in which it acts, affect growth, development, and physiological responses. It's not nutrient or a vitamin.